Listen up, Alaska is right around the corner.
You think? We're almost here. Look at all this greenery.
If you've been following us, you know that one of our biggest dreams was to RV in Alaska, and we're finally doing it. And let's just take it back for a second, because while we were cleaning out the rig and preparing and packing and all the things you have to do, we were like, holy cow, we have a lot of things we've upgraded that we've never shared with you guys.
Today, we just want to keep it light, fun, and hang out with you guys. You're our peeps, by the way, so we always want to travel with you and set you up for the best success as we go along.
Yeah, that's true, because some of these items, I don't know if I could live without now. And I'm like, why did we go so long without this?
Come in to my other home. That is the $1 million question.
That is the Hanks way of doing things, right? We're like late to the food bowl for everything.
And the other way of Hanks way of doing things is just taking our good old time to get into the topic, right? So without further ado, let's just go.
Okay, come on, we got this.
All right, what about them?
Well, bring them along, come on.
Sorry about that, goodness. I'll carry y'all, okay? You're not too heavy for me. Yeah, there we are, okay, let's go. Goodness gracious, you got your racing pants on. Hey, where'd you go? Oh!
Peekaboo!
What are you doing in there?
Hanging out in the wet bay.
I love how you're looking at me like I'm the crazy one for not assuming you're just hanging out in there.
Carl, we all know you spend a lot of time in here, and that's a touchy subject. So why am I in here, besides the fact that we're always in here? I want to show you one of our favorite upgrades. It's our first one. Can we put some light on the subject? That doesn't work. Once again, I don't know why we waited so long to get a good water filtration system, but we've heard so many great things about Clearsource, so we went for it. Fantastic. We drink the water right from the spigot because, like the faucet, the spigot, the faucet. Not to mention this fancy schmancy upgrade that we did. Can't you tell we're proud of it? Carl, you take over from here and talk about your wonderful project.
I'm just gonna be straightforward with you guys. Why do we love it? Well, we were getting sick of going to Walmart and buying huge cases of water. Now we're completely hands off whenever we get to the campground. We can just turn on the water, like Nay said, to the spigot. It is so stinking easy to plug in when we get to the campground. No longer do I have to twist those Walmart filters on and like chew through those like no tomorrow. All we do is hook the hose up, and let me show you. We came up with a tiny little mod on top of it that we just plug in right here with a quick connect. How cool is that? My favorite part about this whole install is these water filters last for about 4 months. Back to my original point, we're not having to chew through these water filters. We kind of just set and forget. Can't beat that. Oh, by the way, guys, everything that we talk about today is in the description below. Now, I know y'all are watching it on the TV, so what you're gonna have to do is jump over to your phone or a nearby computer to get to the description. You're gonna see all of our discount codes there, and you're also gonna see timestamps as we go along, so you can skim forward or backwards and just take notes accordingly. One last thing. Make sure you hit the show more at the bottom, and that will bring up more of the description, because when you get down there, you're gonna be like, where is everything? Well, trust me, show more and you'll find out.
I got the next one. I'm gonna bring it to you, and I want you to talk about this next one, Carl.
Passer here.
Let me turn it on.
No. Way to go, Nene.
I'm sorry.
Kidding. This is my bad. I got excited with the fingers. This is a TPMS system. I cannot express to you more than what I'm expressing right now of how much I hated these things before I got one. You know that annoying beeping we had like many episodes ago?
Oh no. Oh no. What is that?
What is that?
Don't know what's happening anymore.
Yeah. No more. Two of my favorite things about this. One, it directly links up to the TPMS sensors immediately. All you have to do is bring the sensor to the screen. It does a little satisfying beep beep, and then it's reading. And the second thing that I really, really appreciate about this is it has a pass-through valve stem where you don't have to take the sensor off to get a tire pressure or fill up the tires. It has a little rubber nipple on the end where you just unscrew that. You can put air in, pull air out, do whatever you want. Keep it simple.
Next up, I think you're really gonna like this one.
What are you doing?
I take a nap. Notice anything different? I'll give you a second. We finally upgraded our RV mattress. I don't know what it is about the Hanks and like holding off on things that we need for so long. You know how we just talked about that before? Yeah, this is one of those upgrades. We have been doing months, almost a year worth of research on a new mattress, and we just had no idea what to go with until we stumbled upon RV Mattress by Brooklyn Bedding. As you guys know, when you buy an RV at the dealership, fresh off the lot, they come with, I don't know what it is, a piece of cardboard as the mattress. So pretty much everyone ends up having to get a mattress because you're not gonna sleep on that thing, trust me. We have now moved our movie nights from downstairs up here because it is so comfy. We went ahead and got the Signature Hybrid with the cloud top pillow, and it legit feels like you're sleeping on a cloud. We've had the mattress for over a month now, and we wanted to give ourselves plenty of time to make sure it was a great fit, not just for us, but for you guys as well. Here is the best part about getting a mattress through them is they have custom sizes.
Dexter approved? Dexter approved.
The best part about this mattress that really sold me on it is they'll ship you any mattress nationwide and they'll ship it really fast.
And let me talk about satisfying once again. We laid it out, punctured the plastic, and it opened up like flavored buttery biscuits out of those Pillsbury cans, you know what I'm saying? I'm throwing it on the line. I'm throwing it all on the bed and saying, this is probably the most important thing you're gonna need in your RV life. Make sure you sleep good at night.
All right, moving right along. Nay, now that you're behind me, do you want to take the next one? Nay.
Hey.
RV life. I'm ready. All right, what do you got next for us, Carl?
I'm just gonna throw it out there. If you guys are anything like me and you get overheated really quickly, keep your ears open on this one. If you've ever had any experience with RV life, you know that travel days could lead to really stressful hot times. Especially when you get to the campground, you walk into your RV and it's like a sauna in here. And no matter how low you crank that AC, it just ain't catching up. We got a solution. And I wish we would have jumped on this a little bit sooner because I know going forward, we're never gonna not have this. I'm talking about RV airflows. Eyes down here. Basically, RV airflow is a treated piece of styrofoam you place up into the cavity of your AC and it redirects that airflow throughout your whole RV. There's a lot of space up there where that cool air can get lost. This takes that and eliminates it completely. We didn't just do this to one AC, we did it to both of them. And let me tell you, after doing it, it's like a winter solstice in the RV with these ACs running. Now my favorite part is, we can actually just have one AC in the bedroom running and it cools down the whole RV. So you can only imagine if two are running at one time. And granted, if you're ever at a 30 amp only connection place or you just have one AC, you're gonna be good to go. Now, if you're looking for a little bit more of a detailed, like, okay, what's the catch? Really, there is no catch, but we did test it in another video from before to after and how much it increased the airflow. And let me tell you, you're gonna wanna go check out this one after finishing this video. I'll leave it right there.
Let's bring you on over because I have something to show you. You probably have seen it in prior videos, but we have not talked about it yet. Yeah. Excuse me, eyes down here. We went ahead and upgraded from the freestanding dinette chairs to the storage benches. Now hear me out. The dinette chairs, yeah, they look great. They have a residential feel to it inside your RV. They are not very practical, and not to mention you have to secure them on travel days. No more of that. We decided we need more space for things because that's how this lifestyle goes, and we went ahead and got these storage benches on Amazon. We decided to go with the cute little teal color, and we were so worried we were gonna regret it. No regrets. Fantastic. And then when people are hanging out, I have noticed actually when we're all hanging out with friends that the first place people migrate to when they come through that door is right here. Every time. I could be cooking over there and friends are over here while we're talking.
Is this seat taken?
Oh yeah. Wow, you got this figured out. Nice.
Upgrading the recliners has been my happy place. We had old brown leather ones that came with the original unit. We live in a Grand Design Solitude. We like those, but what we found was that the leather got scratched up really quickly, especially with Dexter. We had to quickly get rid of those because the aesthetics of inside were diminishing very fast. We ended up going with these from Lipper. They're cloth, they work great, they have heated massage. So if you are overdue for upgrading your recliners, we like the Lipper ones, and if you want the same ones, we'll leave them linked as well.
They'll send them right to your RV park. They're not very heavy. We were able to lift them in ourselves and donate our old ones. Dexter approved.
All right, these next two go hand in hand and we're really excited to share it with you. Let's start off with the first one. Satellite internet, baby. No longer do we have to worry about places with no cell phone service. We can throw this bad boy up outside, and as long as we have a clear view of the sky, we can have internet, we can make phone calls, we can do downloads, we can stream. We still have our internet cell phone data plans just in case as a backup, but for the most part, when we are out in the boontillies, middle of nowhere desert, Starlink is pumping. If you're wondering if Starlink is right for you, we did a video just on that. We talked about the pros and cons of having Starlink because nothing is ever perfect out there. We'll leave that video linked above. And if you want to see if Starlink is a good fit for you on the road, please watch that when you're done this one. The reason we're talking about having Starlink is because of this next upgrade. Man, it's finally time to talk about this. We've had it since, I think, December, but we went ahead and installed the Micro Air because we wanted something that I can control the temperature from the bed or the couch or outside or on the road. This relies on Wi-Fi and it will monitor the temperature for you whether you're out and about or you're here. I could literally be out shopping and see that it's cold in the area here and I can set the heater to kick on from my phone so that by the time I come back to the RV, it is nice and toasty. The install was so easy, a nene could do it. That's right, I did the install myself. It was literally just taking out the old thermostat and matching up the wires. Pretty much plug and play. AC, heat pump, furnace. I have a hard time getting out of bed in the morning, and now that we have a wonderful new mattress, it is even harder. When you have those chilly mornings and you don't want to be running the furnace continuous all night, you can set this bad boy to kick on at a certain time. Yes, ladies, hear me out. No longer do you have to get up and freeze your butt off to go to the furnace and then wait for it to warm up, and then the mornings aren't so terrible. See how RV life can be just like living in a house? Oh, you know what else is cool? Because we talked about, you know, travel days when you get to a campground and it's so hot inside. As soon as we plug in the rig, none of us have to come in to turn this on. I could just connect via Bluetooth and have the ACs kicking on before even opening the door.
Are you guys still in there with us? If you are, lucky you, for all the other people that left and they're not watching any longer, you get the first scoop on this. We're so excited to show you guys. Come on. Come in to my other home.
Nene just converted this storage space into my other bedroom. So, welcome.
Finally, Hanks, you listened to us. You know what? We did. And for that, I say thank you. High five. On the couch, if I don't feel that energy, I need you to high five me. High five. Yeah. All right. That's better. Look at these bad boys. We finally got lithium batteries, guys.
I cannot tell you how much of a game changer this has been. The reason I say that is because it has opened up so many more avenues for us on the road. Why didn't you guys tell us about this sooner? I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. I know you guys have been harping on us to get this and we finally listened. We're a little hard-headed, aren't we? We got an inverter, two lithium batteries, and a battery charger. They are the Lion Safari 1300s. I think they're like 105 amp hours each. Listen, I'm not gonna bore you with all of the statistics on them. We're still in a working process of getting it all figured out. As you can see, it's a mess back here. Get this though. The other day, we were able to stay on our first Harvest Host golf course. We stayed there for absolutely free, but we went and paid for a round of golf, 18 holes. For like $21. We camped there, we had power, we were able to watch some TV at night, run the fans, the pressure was off. I cannot wait to take you guys along for the journey as we continue our travels up to Alaska. I wanna share with you the ins and outs of how we like them, if you're gonna benefit from them, what are some things that you can look forward to in case we need to add more as we go along. Listen, that's why you gotta stick around. And while you're waiting for those episodes to come out, check out these other two right here. You'll see one that you might like to watch, and you see another that maybe you could start from the beginning. We love you guys, and we'll see you next week.